Hi friends, welcome to Pictures and Paintings.
Rainbow lorikeets. These are one of the most colorful, beautiful parrot species you will find. What drew me towards painting this particular picture is the pose of the particular bird. I got a feeling that it is ready to fly anytime. In fact, that's where I titled this picture as Flight Risk. Flight risk is a corporate terminology that is used to indicate an employee might move on and go to another company. I had a similar feeling when I looked at this particular parrot. The kind of expression it had in its face and the kind of I am ready to fly now kind of a body posture it had. I was curious to see whether I can depict that. And the original reference which I had did not have these pink flowers, it had a yellow flower, but then I felt it would be too much of information for the size of the paper that I'm using. So I decided to replace that flower with a different flower from another reference image. And what I also wanted to consciously do in this particular painting is to keep the details light and painterly. My previous painting, Beauty and the Beast, while I was overall happy with how I had got the look of it, I felt that there is too much of detail going on here, and this area is definitely a lot more overworked. And this is the kind of detail which I liked. I'm fine with the details being there in some portions where the attention should go, but overall where it is not that important, I would like to keep the details at. So that is one thing I try to consciously get right in this. Simplify more. Keep it simple. This is Sivaraman. Today I'm going to walk you through how I painted this colorful bird.
As usual, I started the sketching by roughly blocking the shape of the bird quickly. Once I was happy with the position and the size of the bird within the page, I started detailing. The biggest element of this particular picture is the curiosity you can see in the face of the bird. So I took my time to sketch the beak and eyes, which is going to be emoting that expression. So once that is done, the next big step for me is to decide where the feather details are going to be coming. This is a mid-range shot. Unlike a close-up where the feather details are very clearly seen, it's easy to get away by just hinting the presence of feathers on the bird. Once that is done, I started sketching the branch and the flowers in the branch. The flowers were intricate and I was caught in two minds because I know it is going to be challenging the attention on the bird. But still I liked the flowers and I finally decided to go with them. And I should admit, I had a lot of fun while sketching as well as painting these flowers. The bird's beak had a beautiful warm color, and the interesting part which I wanted to get right when I was painting the beak is to get the shiny nature of the beak. It's fairly simple and goes a long way in establishing that it's a very glossy surface. We call it the highlights, and this highlight differs from material to material. One of the ways to get these highlights is to paint around it. I basically left the white highlight and painted around it. From this distance, we would not notice too much of cracks and lines in the beak, so I did not bother to add that kind of a detail which I have been normally adding in my previous paintings. Decided to keep it simple. One subtle addition, which I'm sure you would notice, is the tonal variation inside the mouth. Through the open beak, you see the inside part of the beak, so it has to be dark in color, but then a little bit of the color tone of the beak would make it look like the light is actually scattering inside. Giving that little translucence makes it look very lively. Painting the eyes of this lorikeet parrot was a very pleasant experience. In fact, I got it right in the first wash itself, which was a very satisfying experience. These parrots have a red cornea, and when it is not handled correctly, it can give a very devilish look. So in fact, to be on the safer side, I ensured the red color doesn't stand out much. Normally, to make a painting look more appealing, you either exaggerate things or you keep things subdued. This is a place where keeping it toned down from reality really worked out for me. These birds are called rainbow lorikeets for a reason. The amount of different color shades they have in them is just amazing. I really enjoyed painting the bird, and I'm sure sometime I'm going to again do another picture of these birds. The neck had a lot of warm shades in them, so I had to be conscious to ensure all the different shades are readable, be it the lemon yellow that I have used, the permanent orange, or the little shades of red. I also had to be conscious the colors don't overlap and blend much, but at the same time the edges are not very hard and they stand out as patches. So I used a little bit of water to blend those shades, and also the small little touch is adding that little water drop which scattered the paint and gave a nice little bloom. I'm again becoming more conscious to not overdo the bloom, but I'm finding it really, really helpful when it comes to creating a little variation when the color is spread very evenly across a portion of the body. A similar bloom technique on the upper half of the wing also really worked out. For the wings again, I ensured I used the darker shades of green to give the variation and make the feathers look like they are folded in. During sketching stages, once I started drawing a couple of flowers, I started noticing the lower half had a lot of negative space on the right hand side. I knew I might have to fill this space, but then I thought I will take that call a little later once I'm into painting, because there is a chance if it doesn't look very odd, I was just thinking I will just fill it up with a little bit of background color and leave it without actually without adding any element there. Once I finished painting the parrot, the negative space was looking even more obvious. So I went ahead and added the third flower and used masking fluid to mask the thin portion of the flowers. My plan was to use a wet on wet technique for the background, so I did not want the paint to be running over the flower. So using masking fluid is one of the easiest ways to keep the paint out over regions where you don't want the paint to be flowing in. I haven't been very successful with my attempts with the masking fluid in the past, so I was keeping my fingers crossed, but I did not really have an option there. The background was pretty straightforward. I decided to repeat the colors which I had used for painting the bird, but kept the background very subtle. Once the bird and the background was done, I started painting the branch and the flowers. I knew it was going to be tedious just because of the structure of the flower, and in fact it was. It really tested my patience. My first pass was very pale and light. Once all the three flowers were done, I called it finished. But after observing the picture for some time, I wasn't too happy with the contrast. So did one more contrast pass, added a little bit more dark regions, and then that's it. I was done. With this, we have come to the end of this video. Me and my daughter keep posting our paintings in this particular channel. We would like to stay in touch with you and keep sharing our work. If you like what you saw, please hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so that we can stay in touch. If you like this particular painting and want to see a more detailed version of how I went about doing this, you can check detailed videos that are published in three parts. Links are here.
Thank you for watching this. See you soon in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.